the weather synopsis for September 5th, 2013. Why the Pacific Northwest is expected to receive strong or severe storms and significant rainfall today through Friday. Thunderstorms producing heavy rainfall and frequent lightning have already been observed across portions of Washington and Oregon the past several days. Flash flood watches have been posted for some locations. This weather briefing will discuss the weather pattern responsible for the numerous showers and thunderstorms and why significant rainfall and strong or severe thunderstorms are possible today through Friday. This water vapor satellite, taken at 3:30 a.m. Thursday morning, shows the location of a deep, low-pressure system off the coast of Oregon. Upper-level winds are from the south ahead of the low. This has allowed moisture off the Pacific to spread across Oregon and Washington. The atmosphere is unstable, and any upper-level disturbance rotating around the low can trigger thunderstorms. The deep upper low off the coast will track eastward across Washington and Oregon today through Friday. There will be significant forcing associated with the system to enhance showers and thunderstorms across the region. This image shows the general position of the low by early Friday morning, September 6. The image you see here shows the current dew points across the region. Surface dew points tell forecasters just how moist the atmosphere is at the surface. High dew points can also indicate the potential for thunderstorms and whether storms will bring heavy rain. Has it appeared unusually humid the past couple of days? The dew points have been in the 50s since early this week, and these are high numbers for eastern Washington and eastern Oregon. There may be dew points as high as the lower 60s in some areas this afternoon. The Storm Prediction Center in Norman, Oklahoma, has placed most of eastern Washington and northeast Oregon in a slight risk of severe thunderstorms today and tonight. The biggest threat with thunderstorms will be heavy rain and large hail. Strong outflow winds are also possible. Residents near wildfires that burned over the past couple of years are strongly encouraged to keep a close eye on debris flows. If storms move over these areas and bring heavy rain, there is little preparation time to seek higher ground. Rain may not penetrate through ash, and the surface will wash down steep terrain. A few burn scar locations to monitor will be the Taylor Bridge, Table Mountain, and Colocum Tarp fires in Kittitas County, Mile Marker 28 fire in Klickitat County, and the Government Flat Complex fire in Wasco County. These areas are under flash flood watches. For the latest updates, check our website at weather.gov/Pendleton or listen to No Weather Radio. Your mobile devices may be designed to receive the latest alerts. Contact your service provider for more information. Follow us on Facebook and Twitter and let us know if you are observing significant weather in your area. On behalf of the staff at the National Weather Service in Pendleton, thank you for listening. Be safe and keep an eye on the weather.